My ex-husband's lawyer is so huge he towers over me like Quasimodo, without the hump or the feeling, stomping over my heart with his Nazi boots, slogging through the years of love. Lammy is scary, Mommy. Lammy needs to take a bathtub. Lammy needs a new eye. Lammy has the chicken pops. The pops, Mama. Lammy is scary. Lammy is the first present I ever gave to her dad. The Christmas before she was born. So she slept with the lamb since she was inside me, and I held him close to my own round body. Around his neck, long since gone, Lammy had a biblical verse about the meek, something like that. Lammy's leg is sewn on sideways. Well, not perfect. So Lammy is Fred Astaire, never takes a step without dancing, never skips a beat. Lammy's up for dance in Florida, the last free state. Oh, you're the best little girl in the whole wide baby world. Every night I tell her, the whole wide baby world. And what about Lammy, she asks. What about him? Oh, the best little lamb in the whole wide Lammy world. Oh, yes. $7,000 in legal fees. And the last thing I whispered to my lawyer before we enter court, free the lamb.
When he smashed my face into a table. Red, my daughter's mouth. He had beat her that hard, he said. And besides, it was only about humiliation. My ex-husband looks like the guy you buy a Toyota from. In fact, he is the guy who sells cars on TV, but it's probably nothing like the guy who actually walks around the unweeded parking lot year after year, selling false promises and hope, looking small and mean. But who I like to picture joyfully brings back his paycheck to children without scars, irretrievably injured.